became involved with Black Tape through my father, Oscar Herrera. He was their vocalist on their first 7 albums from 86 to 99. And actually in 97, I went on a small tour with them when I was 12. So my involvement actually kind of started then. Fast forward 16 years from 1999, my dad gets a call from Sam asking him if he'd like to be part of his new album that he's working on, which ended up being These Fleeting Moments, and said that he would be flying my dad out to Portland, Oregon, where he lives, to record it. I asked my dad if I could join since I had never been there, and my dad said, "Hey, I have a better idea. How about we ask him if you could sing on the album?" So we sent him a recording of me singing through Sky Blue Rooms, and after that it became Black Tape's new female vocalist. No, I do not write any music or lyrics for Black Tape. I'm just the vocalist. This is Sam's project, no pun intended, and I like that I'm actually the storyteller, not the story writer. But if he ever wanted to collaborate on something in the future, I'm always open to that. But for now, I'm happy just singing.
I haven't left the house in days, calling in sick with spirits watching. Drinking alone, I'm thinking you'll abandon me. When you keep finding me like this, of course I can stop. I promise I'll stop.
I am comfortable with singing songs with risque content, absolutely. I've never been shy, that's not something that's ever been an issue of mine. I have always been open about how I feel and my emotions. I don't know how else to be. Sam's songs are packed with emotional content, so to get in that mood, I just draw on something that has happened in my life, past experiences, a moment, a feeling, anything. Specifically for the song, Does Anything Remain, Sam had emailed me and asked me just for some feedback on it, because he knew that I have not had a drink for almost 4 years now, and that's, you know, alcoholism is something that I battled with. It's still, you know, part of my life. It's not something that ever goes away, and that song very much touches on that. And it was actually nice to sing about it, because it was something that I very much felt and definitely identified with, and drawing from the loneliness and sadness that I felt, it was very, very easy to interpret that song, as well as others that I've sung.